Hi, I'm Joshua Trick, and I'm a software developer for Microsoft Teams. I'm here to talk today about authentication in apps for Microsoft Teams. To begin with, I would just like to say for the examples and demos you're about to see, all of this code can be found at our GitHub repo, seen here on the screen, and can be downloaded and ran locally yourself. To begin with, let's talk about a high-level overview of how authentication works within the Teams platform. Whether you're talking about a tab, a bot, or a messaging extension, all of the various flows have a similar pattern. The tab, bot, or messaging extension, using the SDKs, will tell the Teams platform to open a pop-up starting with a page that you own on your domain. That start page will then redirect to the identity provider, the authentication host that you're trying to have your user log into. Once that authentication is complete, that page will redirect to a page you own again with the same domain that you own from the start page. This redirect or end page will use the SDK and notify Teams of a success or failure status, which will then give information back to your app. Let's look at authentication in tabs. With that general pattern, the only differences between tabs and other flows are the starts and the ends. For the basic tab flow, your tab content or config page will present the user with a button that they will click on to notify Teams to open the authentication pop-up. That pop-up, just like with the overview, will first open a page on a domain you own. That page will then redirect to the identity provider, which will then, upon authentication, redirect back to a page on your domain that you own so that you can use the JavaScript SDK to notify Teams of success or failure. Specifically for the tab flow, that success or failure should get the end page to either set a cookie or store the token and information in the local storage so that your content or config page can use it for later processing. So, let's see what this would look like in a real-world situation. So for this tab auth flow, as mentioned, we have our content URL, and we have our button, which is going to tell, using the JavaScript SDK, Teams, that it's time to open the authentication pop-up. With that call to authenticate, we can click, come to the start page, and redirect to our AAD login page. With that login page, I can log in, and now when I redirect after this login, I will redirect back to the page that I own, which will tell Teams to close this pop-up and send that information down to the content page. Because that authentication page closed, it notified our content page that the authentication was complete and it was time to take the token and find the profile for this user, which is the person that just logged in. Now, let's look at the code that made all of that possible. So, for the code that made that possible, we first start with our content page, which is hosted with the simple HBS file. The first step that page does is import the JavaScript SDK for Teams. Within the JavaScript, it then initializes the Microsoft Teams object, and the button callback is linked to the login URL command, which calls the Microsoft Teams.authentication.authenticate call, which is actually the call that tells Teams to open the pop-up. In order to do that, we first have to give it a URL, and then we actually give it success callbacks and failures based upon what that pop-up flow notifies us in return. For us, that success callback is simply going to take, get the token out of local storage, and then get the user's profile with that token. So when the user clicks on that button and the authentication pop-up is created, that pop-up is hosted for us by this URL, which is the simple start page. The simple start page simply navigates and redirects the page to the login for AAD. That login for AAD, as we saw, allows the user to log in, and then upon completion of that, redirects to our simple end file. Here, we import the SDK, initialize the Microsoft Teams object, and then based upon the parameters we received, we can either notify of failure or success. For us, because we know we authenticated successfully, we're going to go down the successful route by taking and storing in local storage the token, and then notifying Teams of success with the key to get that token out of the local storage. This then can be caught again back on our content page in our success callback. Now let's take a look at authentication in bots. For the basic bot login, the user will indicate to the bot that it's time to log in, and the bot will respond with a button of the sign-in action type. The user will then click the sign-in action type, which will tell the Teams platform to open another authentication pop-up similar to the one in the tab. That will open onto the start page for a domain that you own. That start page will redirect to the identity provider, and after authentication is completed, will redirect back to the end page on a domain that you own. That end page's job is to, using the SDK, notify the Teams platform of success or failure. Different than the tab authentication flow, this success or failure will actually get the Teams platform to send an invoke message of a specific type back to your bot so that it can do what it needs to. So, let's see what that looks like within Teams. For our bot demo, we have our authentication bot, which actually provides multiple logins and identity providers. For this scenario, we're going to use the LinkedIn example to show that it's just as easy to have a third-party provider as it is for AAD. So, for our LinkedIn flow, I'm going to sign in. And for that authentication flow, what the bot has now done is sent a sign-in button that when I click on it, it's going to tell the Teams platform to open a pop-up for the authentication. So I've now opened to, first, my domain page, which redirected to the LinkedIn login page. And now, if I log in here, upon doing this successfully, it's going to redirect back to my domain, notify success, and tell the bot that I logged in successfully. With that token, I can now have the bot get my profile and show my information. Let's go ahead and take a look at the code that made that possible. In order to kick off the login flow for the bot, the user will send the sign-in command, which will fall into the handle login command. That command will first create a sign-in URL and then return a card with the sign-in action opening to that URL. That sign-in action, when the user clicks on it, will notify the Teams platform to open the pop-up to that page. That page, which is rendered with auth start, will take the context and redirect to the appropriate identity provider. That identity provider will allow the user to log in, send the authentication information to the back end of the bot, and the back end of the bot will store the information and send, in the OAuth callback success handlebars page, a verification code in order to verify that the user that signed in is actually the user that's talking to this bot. For the OAuth callback success handlebars page, the first thing that it will do is import the JavaScript SDK, initialize the Microsoft Teams object, and then notify success with that verification code. What this call of notify success to the Microsoft Teams object in the bot context will do is tell the Microsoft Teams platform to send a special invoke message with the sign-in type, with this verification code back to the bot. When the bot receives this invoke message, it will then get navigated to the handle login callback page. This handle login callback page, upon receiving that invoke message, will take that verification code and validate that the currently logged in user and the user that's talking to the bot are the same person. This then will allow the bot to safely use this token in order to get information like the LinkedIn profile. Having seen those flows, there are a few things to remember. First, the pop-up flow has to start on a page on a domain that you own and end on that end page with that same domain. So, as we see in this example, if you start the pop-up flow with myapp.com, you have to end the flow on myapp.com in order for Teams to know to properly close the pop-up. Next, in order for the Teams platform to allow that pop-up to be opened, you need to make sure that you add your domain that you're wanting to open in the manifest in the valid domains list. For AAD specific authentication, for the various types of users we can have within the Teams platform, make sure you use the tenant ID specific login URL rather than the common URL. This tenant ID can be found either in the tab context in the TID parameter or in the channeldata.tenant.id section of a bot message. We get asked a lot how a tab, a bot, and a compose extension can share state and which IDs will be the same between the different contexts. The AAD object ID or user ID will be the ID that you can use in all the contexts to know that you're talking to the same user. In order to do these login flows, the information needed for the bot flow is actually located within the bot's message in either the AAD object ID or the tenant ID field. And finally, for these and other resources, you can navigate to these URLs to find either the sample we did here, various other samples, or our Microsoft Teams documentation. Thank you.